Finally, the age of having to remember all your website passwords is over. Well, almost. Probably. Because there is a new protocol in town. How exciting! I know you guys love to hear about protocols, but it actually is a little bit more interesting than it may sound. So hopefully you'll stick around and you'll get a glimpse of how we may log into websites in the near future, like within the next couple years tops, and maybe even this year, starting for some of you guys who are willing to be early adopters. Now, this new protocol is called WebAuthn, short for Web Authentication. And it basically is a new method for supporting two-factor authentication using physical device keys or biometric devices, including those on your phone, or maybe your laptop has one as well. And I've actually talked about a similar technology in the past called U2F, which basically uses a physical security key that has some encryption going on in there, where you tap the side of it while it's plugged into the computer, and that is enough to prove that you have that factor of authentication, you can't be phished. But this is a little bit different because it does kind of support that same technology with a security key and biometrics, but it has another trick up its sleeve, this new protocol, which is that it doesn't require passwords at all. You can use it as your only method of logging in. And what's also more important about this protocol is, unlike U2F, which didn't really take hold all over the place, this new one is getting big pushes by like Google, Microsoft, and is actually being supported in all major browsers. So the next version of Chrome 67 will support it, and it actually is already in the 67 beta. There's also the new Firefox 60, the latest public version, does support it, and Microsoft Edge as well should soon. So already it's ahead of the U2F, which was already a really good protocol, it just wasn't really supported that much, and it does support more features. So this is probably something that we are going to see for sure, more adoption from companies. So you may be thinking, ah, this is just a bunch of theoretical stuff, we're not gonna really see this anytime soon, are we? Actually, there's already a live demo page called webauthn.org that you can go to, and if you're using Firefox 60, which does support it, you can actually literally use this protocol. Now, I can do it because I have one of those U2F security keys, which also does support WebAuthn. They kind of adopted a lot of the same technology into this, so I can use it, but if you don't have one of those, you might not be able to. But I'll show you the example right now so you can at least see. So when you go to this website and you want to register for this example, you literally just type in a username and hit register. And then in this case, Firefox kind of prompts you to let you know that the site is asking you to register with this encryption token that you have built into the browser and in that device. And then when you press on the U2F key, in this case, it will create the whole key pair, do all the stuff in the background, and create that login. And now you are registered for that website. And then when you go to log in, it's just as easy. You type in the username and click login. It will ask you to tap the thing with your key, which is unique. You tap it and you're logged in, and that's it. No need to type in a password or anything. Now, at this point, there are some hurdles that it will need to overcome before getting widespread adoption by users, at least. And the biggest one being that you need some sort of device that will support that protocol. So in this case, if it's on a desktop, you probably need a key of some kind, like a YubiKey or one of the basic ones that I have, which aren't expensive, by the way, and I've recommended in the past for regular two-factor authentication, but that's besides the point. But also, it is probably going to be supporting fingerprint sensors built right into phones, and that's going to be down to the manufacturers. Obviously, Google is pushing this, so Android, it's going to work with Android, no doubt, and I'm assuming Apple isn't going to want to be behind the times, especially if a lot of websites start pushing this, and Apple users start saying, wait, why can't I use this on iPhone? And then that'll be all it takes. They'll implement it then. But as you may know, a lot of laptops these days have fingerprint sensors built right into the laptop for using login with Windows Hello or anything else. else. So I think we're gonna start to see adoption faster than you may realize. So what about some downsides? We can kind of mention those and also some solutions. And the first one that I notice is that if you're using one of those security keys and you just tap the side, well, it doesn't check your fingerprint, obviously. There's no fingerprint sensor on there. So theoretically, if you just keep that plugged into your computer, someone you don't really want using your computer, like a friend, could go and log into all your websites, but maybe if you keep it on your keychain or something. And then also what could be supported is maybe phones being able to hook up to your computer, so it's by Bluetooth, or maybe some sort of other device that you carry around all the time. You don't even have to plug it in. It automatically connects to your computer or anything else, and that would literally be just as easy as something that you keep plugged in. Another obvious issue is, what if you lose the key or you break your phone and have to get a new one, and then those software keys stored on those old ones are gone? You have to use a unique one, and it's not gonna be on any new one. And I think obviously we could probably use passwords as a backup and recovery in that case, or maybe obviously email as a recovery. So you would hopefully still have access to your email address, and then you could use that to temporarily log in and register your keys again. Or another option is using a token generator on your phone, like we do now for two-factor authentication. We could use that as like a backup. Now you may be thinking, wait a minute, that sounds great. There's no password, but that is no longer two-factor authentication anymore. That's just one-factor authentication. And yeah, that's true. If you're just using one of the keys where you tap the side, that is just one factor of authentication. But if you have a fingerprint sensor added to the mix, you like on your phone, or maybe if they do start implementing these keys with fingerprint sensors built in, that's basically two methods right off the bat, automatically. Because think about it this way, it's pretty common that there's, I think, three methods of authentication generally, and those are something you know, like a password, something you have, like a token generator app or a cryptographic key, and the third one is something you are, so that would be like a fingerprint or an iris scanner. So if you had one of these keys where you have to touch it and have the key physically there, that's something you have, as well as the fingerprint sensor built into it, that's also something you are. So it's like two in one. And the reason that would be important is then even if someone steals the key, they have something you are supposed to have, but they can never get what you are. They would have to force you to do it by yourself. So they wouldn't be able to get in because they only have one of those factors. And at this point, you might be thinking, well, that sounds great, but is there any actual websites that support this protocol yet? And the answer is yes, kind of. The first one is at least Dropbox. They announced pretty recently, actually, like just within the last month, that they do support this WebAuthn, Web Authentication protocol. Now, they use it now as a method of two-factor authentication, not as a pure login. So you still need to have to use your password. But like I said, it's a protocol that you can use in several different ways. You can use it as two-factor authentication, or in the future, we'll probably see more people using it as their only factor. But the benefit, again, for using web authentication is that it is going to be supported by more browsers. So now that Dropbox has that, literally anyone on any browser can use the key, whereas before it would have had to support U2F, which is not all of them. So I really do think we're going to see a lot more support very quickly with this whole web authentication, and maybe even a push to get rid of passwords. I mean, especially with the whole password breaches debacles we've been seeing, it's happening more and more frequently. You have to assume that a password database is going to be breached, and a lot of people do not follow basic password security. But the fact is that a decent number of websites at least do support U2F, which is for the security keys. And since it's basically the same thing, kind of, it shouldn't be that difficult for them to just now implement web authentication. And since it's now going to be supported on basically all browsers, it would be a no-brainer if you already support U2F to then just add this web authentication thing. And it'll kind of be like a domino or snowball effect, I think, because now there is more support on all browsers, more websites that already use two-factor authentication will support this, and then if more users therefore use it, then websites that had this not at all will start implementing it, because again, there's more reason to use it. They'll say, well, at least all users can use it if they want, even if they don't, because all browsers have it. So I'm actually kind of hopeful. I'm thinking really by the end of this year, we might start to see websites that allow you to register with this web authentication method. And definitely websites that will probably allow you to at least log in and then still let you use a password if you want, but also allow this. And this will be especially so on mobile, I think, because typing in passwords is really a pain on mobile even more, because at least on a desktop, it's a lot easier to use like an auto-filling password manager. It's not super supported as much on phones, so if you literally just have to go to the website, log in with a fingerprint, so much easier. So again, I'm hopeful. You guys can let me know what you think. Do you expect to use this? Are you already using like a security key? We can talk about that down in the comments. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make a few new videos every week, so it should be worth it. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys, so thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.